Okay, hello everyone. Welcome back to Persona. I am SIMSteven, also known as Master Fenrel. And we're still exploring the Karma Palace, as usual. Still got a lot left to explore. Well, I don't think we got that much to explore, but we pretty much got the lower levels left in front of us. So, well, let's just keep on going, and we'll see if we can figure out where the Harem Queen is located. And, we're continuing off where we left off from Tuesday's episode. So, I'm doing this in batch, and we just got Kieran's spell card in the last fight. So, we can actually make him run away if we want. And wow, that scream still is freaking creepy. but off screen, when I was just kind of in the pause menu, starting up a new episode, I switched over to Jacko because my Ixil got up to level 8, or rank 8, I should say. So now we can start using fire magic on some of these enemies, and hopefully we won't be, you know, getting our ice magic reflected on us. Or getting just magic in general reflected on us. Oh, and Galen apparently hits... chill out. We're getting a lot of attack all magic now, and that's actually a pretty good thing because it helps us get our levels up quite a bit. So that's kind of nice. Just hopefully we won't get reflected too much because that tends to hurt if you hit everything on the field and they all reflect the magic back at you. That can do some damage if you hurt yourself. Anyways, really like that persona, by the way. A really cool looking one. Fortunately, that one reflects whatever mirror you just cast. Was it Waveball or something like that? I don't remember what it's called, but I really would like Oma to hit rank 7 or 8. Still at rank 6, unfortunately. So it's taking a while for us to level that thing up. Well, at least fire works on these guys, so it's just that one element that Mary's been using that gets reflected. Anywho, regardless, let's just auto battle this and kill him. Probably only take one hit, or two, or three, who knows. But either way, yeah, we're continuing here in the lower levels of the Karma Palace, aka the Harem Dungeon. but yeah, I do want to continue what I was talking about last time, which was just, I was continuing talking about, you know, my channel versus Kappa, and how, you know, it's not my intent to make these videos for kids, and how, well, hopefully the target audience, quote unquote, of these videos are just people who have similar interests like me, people who like me who... just like to play RPGs, have an interest in some of the more niche games that are out there. And that's, for the most part, whatever you'd call my target audience. Not kids, not adults, just anyone who has similar interests like me. And once again, I said before that I'm 36 years old, still playing video games, still have an interest in, you know, pretty much any kind of game out there. In fact, specifically RPGs and just, well, games I want to just showcase for the world that don't get enough love, I guess. Does my commentary do them justice? Probably not. Since, like I've said before, I'm autistic and I tend to use these videos for the sake of trying to get better at speaking. After all, they say you can't get better at something if you don't practice it, so... well, here I am. But yeah, that's just kind of the general idea of why I make these videos. Because, for one, it's fun. It's part of my hobby of playing video games and all that. And, well, it's kind of like just to help myself get better at something that I'm really bad at. And I really should change up the auto battle here, because apparently this thing is very strong against physical attacks. Or just the ones that I've been using. So let's use our personas and kill this thing off. So yeah, that's really just my quote-unquote target audience that I've been going for. And I got the sniffles for whatever reason. I don't know why this happens. Just whenever I start talking for a while, like, especially in these Persona videos where it's like 100% of the time I'm talking, it's just I get sniffles and the crud comes up. And it's not like I'm sick or anything, it just happens once I start talking for a while. And I don't know. It's just, maybe it's just I'm not used to talking for a while and my body has a negative reaction to talking a bunch. Like I said, it's something I'm terrible at, but I guess even my body doesn't like it. but regardless, I think these guys are strong against magic. I think we fought them once a few episodes ago. I think on our last full trip, we fought some of these guys. And yeah, it looks like they're not very... It looks like they're kind of weak against physical, so we're just going to do that here. Kill them off, I guess. I don't know if I really want their spell card. I kind of made the exception for the angels before, but maybe these guys just have a stronger version of the angel card. I don't know. And that's kind of one thing I've noticed, is that I can still make certain personas with some stronger monster cards than compared to some of the cards I had at the beginning of the game. Although I haven't seen some of the weaker personas show up recently. Like, I haven't seen a combination that results in a pixie, for example. Or some of the lower level personas that we've had up to this point. I think even Hellcat, the one that Chris is currently using, I think we haven't seen a combination result in that. So, hopefully, for the most part, we're not screwed out of getting certain personas. Some of the more rare and elusive ones, just because we don't have certain cards. And I would really hate it if this game had a mechanic like that, where if you want to make a certain persona late in the game, you can't because you need a certain card from the very beginning of the game. But hopefully there might be like, maybe there'll be like a dungeon or something. At least that's my hope, is that maybe there's a dungeon where you can find a bunch of low-level monsters. Like, there might be one floor where all the monsters you fight were from the police station. Another floor for all the monsters from the hospital, and maybe another floor for all the monsters that were around town when we first started the game. And the factory, Sebek Corporation. Just, I really hope there's nothing completely missable in this game, but there probably might be. Who knows? I don't know if this game was really, you know, generous, I guess, in that respect. But since I've never played up to this point in the game, or past this point in the game, yeah, I really hope I'm not completely permanently screwed out of getting something rare and elusive. Because it would really suck if I would need to bring, like, a zombie nurse or a zombie cop card towards the end of the game, and fuse it with, like, a monster's card from the end of the game, and make a really souped-up persona. I just really hope that doesn't actually happen later on. Because that would be a really dick move if they made it like that, and if they made a certain persona that you needed to have something from early game and late game, and that's the only way you can get a certain strong persona or something like that. But at least I think the good news is there are substitute cards that come in later on, so that you can at least get something here and now at this point in the game that's kind of on par with what your level should be. So, I guess that's good news. But either way, yeah. Anywho, still got a lot of mings to go through here on this floor. Wow, lots of dead ends here. And I have no idea how close or how far away we are from the Harem Queen. Once again, we're playing this completely blind up to this point, and so I don't know where the exit's going to be or what's coming up. But, well, I think we've kind of done the whole blog thing here. I kind of want to see if we can just get through things quickly here. So I think I might just speed things up. Maybe look up some more music from the soundtrack and put it in here. Last time I actually played Chris's theme and the town map theme from the other side of the barrier because I had said before that I would try and let you listen to the town theme at some point in time or another, but I never really gave you guys a chance to hear it because it had a really weird change in how it sounded, like halfway through the song. It started off sounding all really spooky and foreboding, and then it kind of had a really nice pleasant theme after it played on for a while, so that's kind of why I picked that song. But also try and find some good songs to let you listen to today, since I have a feeling we're just going to music montage this dungeon, speed things up a little bit, and just try and get through this, because I got plenty of time today to do some recording, so I want to get to this dungeon today in this current sitting. So, yeah, let's speed things up and play some tune, and I'll see you once something interesting happens. And that was a nasty back attack. But now I'm going to take a quick break, or a quick pit stop, I should say. Not taking a break now. We're not going to be ending off today's episode, well, today's recording session anytime soon. But I do want to make a quick pit stop to buy the guns that I wanted to buy because, well, I don't know if I'm going to be able to come back here later. And, well, we can stop by the clinic, get healed up as well. And, well, we kind of have a good idea now on where to go if we want to take the most direct route to where we need to be. So, I think what we need to do is take the elevator down to the fourth floor, take that pitfall once again, and take the original path that we took on that pitfall a couple episodes ago where we found, once again, that portrait room. I guess that was kind of an important path to take, because apparently that's the right way, but there was another split somewhere halfway down through that road. And, well, I guess we took the wrong way the first time around, which I guess that's good for me, because what I'm trying to do is map out the whole place, and, well, I think we've got all of the dead ends taken care of, and now we just have the one direct route left to go if we want to get to the Harem Queen. But for now, though, I'm going to buy those two guns that I haven't bought yet, the SPA S15 and another carbine, so that I can equip Nate with that one. Since, well, I gave the stronger one to Chris, simply because he's the newbie, and, well, Nate's been doing pretty good for himself up to this point. Alright, yep. There we go, carbine, and I think the that's weaker version of the Mad Max that we bought not too long ago. Alright, well, I'm going to save real quick, probably going to split the episode here, and then I'm going to keep on going, but I think we have the most direct route we need to go down just to reach the Harem Queen once and for all. Also want to double check to make sure if any of those new spell cards we got can make some cool personas. Plus, we're starting to see characters, or some of our party members are getting into the level 30s, so hopefully we can make some of those stronger personas that we haven't been able to make, which I'm not entirely sure what constitute for whether or not he'll let us make a persona or not. For example, when we tried to make Cerberus with the one I've been trying to make for a while, it says you can't handle it yet, but I wonder what takes that away and makes it so we can handle it. Maybe it's just the level of our party or something like that. I don't know. What was this guy again? Oh, yeah, that weird old guy. Not really interested in him. I don't really see any new names on the list. Have I seen Infernal? Yeah, I keep forgetting which one that is. It's the skeleton dog. Alright, well, I don't think we've got anything really new here that we haven't seen already, so I'm going to take a quick break to save the game, and then I think from here on out, we're going to conquer the rest of the dungeon in the next episode. So, once again, I am SimSteven, also known as Mr. Fenrel, and hopefully, once and for all, we're going to be done with this thing. And I'm ready to just keep on going and get this thing done. But you're going to have to wait till the next episode, so I'll see you guys then.